everyone. Welcome back to integralcalc.com. We're going to be doing another example today where we convert polar coordinates to Cartesian coordinates. So the polar coordinates that we're given are 1, comma, negative pi over 3. And whenever we're dealing with converting polar coordinates to Cartesian coordinates, we're going to use the following two formulas: x equals r cosine theta and y equals r sine theta. So the one thing to keep in mind is that when you have a set of polar coordinates like this, Cartesian coordinates, right, are normally x comma y. Polar coordinates are r comma theta. In other words, r is the radius and theta is the angle. So we have r comma theta, and that means that when we use these two formulas, we're going to be plugging in 1 for r and negative pi over 3 for theta. So let's go ahead and generate our two formulas for x and y. We're going to get the following: x equals 1 cosine of negative pi over 3, and y equals 1 sine of negative pi over 3. And we got those, again, by plugging in 1 from our polar coordinate for r and negative pi over 3 from our polar coordinate for theta in both of these equations for x and y. So now what we need to do is just simplify these two equations here, the x equation and the y equation, and our answer will give us our x and y Cartesian coordinates. So what we'll need to do is use the unit circle here to evaluate these two functions. So one interesting thing about this problem is that they've given us a negative theta, or a negative angle. And there's two ways to look at this. We can either deal with the negative as it is, or we can convert it. So first let's talk about how we would just deal with it as is. Normally, if you were given, for example, the angle positive pi over 3 as this theta coordinate in your polar point, you would look here on the unit circle, and you would move in the positive direction or the counterclockwise direction here to pi over 3, and that would be your angle. So as you may imagine, when your coordinate is negative, when the theta coordinate is negative, you still start at the point 0, and you just move in the negative direction clockwise like this until you have gone pi over 3, an angle of pi over 3. And in this case, if you look, you can see here we have 11 pi over 6, 7 pi over 4, and 5 pi over 3. And that's the giveaway, right? Since we have negative pi over 3, you're looking for the first third angle on the unit circle. So you're looking for the first place where the denominator is going to be equal to 3, which is here at 5 pi over 3. So we could just move in that direction, and we know that we would be evaluating at this point. It's the same as negative pi over 3. If that's uncomfortable for you and you'd rather convert the coordinate so you know for sure what it is on the unit circle, you can subtract pi over 3 from 2 pi. So what that looks like is this. We would say 2 pi minus pi over 3. And keep in mind that it's not minus a negative pi over 3, because then you would be adding. It's just 2 pi minus pi over 3. So you could say that you would add the negative pi over 3 to it. So then you just simplify this by setting this 2 pi equal to 6 pi over 3, so that you can have a common denominator of 3 here. And then you can see that if you have 6 pi over 3 minus pi over 3, you'll end up with 5 pi over 3. That's the converted angle. And just to confirm, that is what we determined the angle would be when we moved in the negative direction around the unit circle. So two ways to verify it. But either way, you're looking at either negative pi over 3 or 5 pi over 3. So remember now that we have these two x and y equations here and here. So for the first one, for the x equation, we're going to be evaluating at the angle negative pi over 3 or 5 pi over 3. And when we're looking at cosine of that angle, that means that we're going to be looking at the x coordinate at this point. At this point, 5 pi over 3. Cosine means we look at the x coordinate. When it's sine, we look at the y coordinate. So in this case, our x equation is going to simplify to 1 times 1 half, because our x coordinate, or cosine of our angle, is 1 half, as you can see here. And similarly, y equals 1 sine of negative pi over 3 is going to give us 1 times the negative square root of 3 over 2, because sine of our angle 5 pi over 3 is the y component, or the y coordinate of our Cartesian point here. So we get negative square root of 3 over 2. So that's our x and y coordinates, and when we put them together, we get the Cartesian coordinate 1/2, negative square root of 3 over 2, and that's how we convert from the polar point 1, negative pi over 3 to a Cartesian point. So I hope that helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!